This morning, our Eye on Earth series looks at the impact of severe drought on California's dwindling salmon population. For the second straight year, dry conditions are stoking fears of another devastating wildfire season. The lack of rain and the snow is also threatening the survival of the salmon. Jonathan Vigliotti shows us a work to save a species that includes a surprising route to the sea. It was designed by a wildlife biologist.
Captain Sarah Bates has been reeling in salmon off the California coast for nearly a decade.
Catching fish never gets old. You know, it doesn't really matter how many times you've done it. Even when you're catching 100 fish a day or more, it's still fun every time.
Wish you were a bigger fish.
Commercial and recreational salmon fishing generates more than $900 million annually for California. But with much of the state in a punishing drought, the fishing industry is feeling the stress.
Nobody can survive an entire season that looks the way that this one is looking. I mean, we are looking at an over 50% reduction of our traditional commercial fishing season.
Because the state experienced one of the driest years on record, waterways that would normally carry young salmon out to sea are now hotbeds of dirt and dust.
I'm standing currently 40 feet underwater, or should be standing 40 feet underwater.
Governor Gavin Newsom declared a drought emergency from a cracked lake bed in April.
The hots are getting hotter, the dries are getting drier.
Iconic Chinook salmon need cold, running water to survive. They hatch in rivers, then migrate to the sea to mature. After a couple years, they swim back to where life began, to reproduce or spawn. But this year, studies show fish born in the wild will likely die. Environmental scientist Jason Julian.
Survival has been shown to be very dependent on temperature as well as flow. And the temperatures that we're seeing now are anticipated to have pretty low survival for fish that are released in the river.
That's why hatcheries like this one near Sacramento are jumping with activity. To save the species, the California Department of Fish and Wildlife has launched a massive operation.
This is pretty incredible. What you're looking at is nearly 700,000 juvenile salmon being sucked up this tube and put into one of seven tankers. With rivers so low, this is what migration looks like, and it's just one stop along this very unusual journey.
The fish are hitching a ride inside 146 trucks, traveling more than 100 miles to the Pacific.
All right, here we go.
John McManus heads up an association of fishermen who advocate for salmon and ecosystem protections.
What does a Herculean effort like this mean for the salmon population?
Well, actually, in the short term, this gives us hope, and we're happy that they're moving these fish. But it's also a very sad testament to what's happening with our rivers in the middle of this state.
What's happening to California's rivers first became a concern nearly a century ago when dams were built to distribute water to crops in the Central Valley. Damming is believed to have destroyed as much as 95% of salmon habitat. Hatcheries have helped make up for some of the loss, but this year's drought means they now have to make up for all of it.
Salmon are the canary in the coal mine. They're a proxy for many other species in the environment that also rely on the very same water, the very same environmental conditions to survive. So when salmon are going down, many other species are going down.
To prevent the tiny fish from becoming a buffet for seabirds, release sites are rotated. These were freed at night beneath the Golden Gate Bridge. We followed our school of fish as they were towed to a spot near Mare Island.
In all, more than 17 million will be released here into the San Francisco Bay. Nothing about this is natural, but it's their best chance at survival.
It's estimated about 80% of the young salmon taken for a ride will grow to maturity. Sarah Bates is appreciative of the work being done to protect the fish and preserve a way of life.
Every fish feels like a little tiny victory. In reality, they're just one part of a much larger ecosystem, and that ecosystem depends on water flows in the California rivers.
For CBS This Morning, Jonathan Vigliotti, San Francisco.
I have to admit, I didn't realize the degree to which the drought would affect the fish population. I mean, this really is a Herculean effort when you're talking about moving 17 million fish.
Yeah, we're trucking them, then we're putting them through that funnel, and then we're taking them out in the middle of the ocean.
Also, down the road, we can catch them and eat them.
And then
we can
eat them down the road. We're going to put them in the restaurant and eat them.
Yeah,
you can order them.
Yeah.